seated. Dearly beloved, we are gathered together here in the sight of God, in the face of this company, to join together this handsome man and this gorgeous young lady in holy matrimony, which is commended of the Apostle Paul to be honorable among all men, and therefore is not to be entered into lightly, but advisedly, reverently, discreetly, and in the fear of God. And to this holy estate, these two persons come now to be joined. Austin, will you have this woman to be your wedded wife, to live together after God's ordinance in the holy estate of matrimony? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaken all others, keep her unto you as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Kaitlynn, will you have this man to be your wedded husband, to live together after God's ordinance in the holy estate of matrimony? Will you love him, honor, submit to him, and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaken all others, keep him unto you as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Who gives this woman to be married to this man?
Her father and I, her mother.
Amen.
And I.
Awesome. Awesome. Well done. All right, you want to pass that off? Now you want to hug your daughter? Well done. Now hand them over.
I love you too.
Let's pray together, please. Father, thank you so much for this wonderful occasion. Beautiful day. Wow. Gorgeous day. Gorgeous. Absolutely. And then this beautiful couple. Not just outside. We see that. But I see what's inside. And I've had weeks and months to sit down with them, talk about these events in this day. And I love the hearts of this young couple. I pray they'll never let anything steal that from them. Help them stay focused on the Lord Jesus Christ and all that they say and do. I commit them to you in Jesus' name. Amen. Have you ever had a dessert or a meal or a special dish and you couldn't stop talking about it? I mean, maybe you're invited to a friend's house and you're like, wow. And you're like, so the problem now is you're like, do I ask for the recipe? You know, like, all right, can I have that recipe? Because that was a home run. Maybe it was your favorite special ribs or maybe fried chicken, one of my favorites. All right, cream of crab soup. Us Marylanders know about that, don't we? I'm getting hungry thinking about it. Let's move on. And if you're really into cooking, it's probably some of you to ask, could I have the recipe? Why? Because you'd like to do that at home and have that recipe with you. And that certainly makes sense. But let's talk about marriage for a moment. What if there was actually a recipe for marriage? And would that be something that you'd be interested in? We've talked about that a lot, your marriage and what's coming up here. So I want to suggest to you a recipe. It's a very simple recipe. It's not complicated. If I had to cook something, that would be complicated. But this is not. This is very basic. And not because you couldn't handle more difficult things. I just want to keep it very simple on this day. I want you to picture with me, and you remember one of our lessons, we drew a triangle. Mm-hmm. I want to come back to that, because I think that is absolutely critical. If you could picture a triangle, and I want you to keep triangles in your mind. So going forward here, every time you see a triangle, I want you to remember this discussion we had, not only in the premarital counsel, but also on your wedding day. And we know that at the bottom, there's the three different corners, and at the bottom on one side is Austin, and on the bottom on the other side is Kaitlynn. And what happens a lot of times with couples when they get married, their focus is this way, and it's understandable. Her attractiveness drew you. If she wasn't attractive, we wouldn't be standing here. I get that. If he was a handsome young man, there'd be someone else here. I get that. I know that. That started the path, but that's not how it deepens. The outward is important. Nothing wrong with that one. But I want to get your picture to talk about what's at the top. And we know what's at the top, and that's Jesus. And you know how we talked about that. As you live your lives, if you focus this way, you can nitpick each other. Well, she didn't do this, or he didn't do that, or that didn't happen the way she promised, or whatever, because our focus is this way. But if your focus is on Christ, what happens is you get closer to Christ. You're getting what?
Closer together.
And that's not a trick of any sort. That's just true. That's why Christ wants to be in the center of everything you're doing. Think about Christ. How does he fit into your home? What does it mean going forward? How can I have Jesus in the center of my lives, our lives, in the center of our direction of wherever we go? What would Jesus want us to do? What about this? How does it fit? Always bringing him into the discussion, because he cares about you all. He loves you. And Christ loves the church, and you're to love her the same way. So it's all about putting him there. And when you do that, again, very simple recipe, not a complicated one. It's the recipe of what I say of a great marriage, having Christ in the center of everything you do. Now, let me expand to the audience for just a moment. I believe this is not just a recipe for a great marriage, but I think it's a recipe for a great life. If Jesus is truly the center of your life, you are getting the most out of this life. If Jesus is not the center of your life, you're not getting the most out of this life. I'm telling you, Christ, really, he came to give you life and to give it to you more abundantly. In Christ, that's where life is. He who has the Son has life. He who does not have the Son does not have life. So I want to encourage you to think a lot about, where is Jesus Christ in your life? I want you to have a great marriage, and I look forward to being together with you forever. You know, this isn't just, you know, a wedding day. It's a celebration of Christ, who instituted the marriage himself with Adam and Eve all from the beginning. But he also wants us to have a relationship with him to go to heaven and be with him forever. And so if you're here today and you're not sure about your relationship with Christ, and you may have a good life, I am telling you, Jesus will rock your world. I've seen it happen, and I know what he can do. If I could talk to you about that, or better yet, you can talk to this young couple who have believed with all their heart that Jesus is the Savior and have committed their lives to him. So I commend you forward. Remember, every time you see a triangle, they trigger. So who's the first one? You can play a game. I saw it first. And whoever sees it first has to kiss, whatever. You can come up with some kind of a strategy between yourselves and do it. But every time you see it, remind yourself that Jesus is Jesus. And ask yourself the question, is he in the middle of everything? Is he really there? Are we missing anything? And enjoy life. He wants you to have an awesome marriage. And he will help you keep him right in the center of you. And the choice is yours. So if I have a great recipe for an awesome, awesome meal, and you don't come get it, you know, if I have a recipe for a great marriage and you don't do it, I encourage you to do it. And if you don't have a recipe for a great life, I offer you one, and his name is Jesus Christ. Now we're going to ask Natalie and Heather to come up now. What they're going to do, so you understand, and this has been written beautifully, those whose lips were first to kiss them as they came into the world will now offer one last kiss before they become husband and wife. May the love of their mothers be a reminder of the power of unconditional love and a source of strength to send them on their way to their life together as husband and wife. It's amazing. Now, Austin and Kaitlynn would like to share some vows. Austin, you're going to share yours first.
I, Austin Paul Campbell, take thee, Kaitlynn Marie Lohman, to be my wedded wife. I make these vows and covenant before God to be faithfully upheld for as long as I live. I solemnly vow to always strive to love you as Christ loved the church, with patience, grace, truth, servitude, and faithfulness. I vow to lead you and our family in a manner pleasing to God. I vow to do my best to protect and comfort you in all circumstances, both good and bad, no matter what life throws at us. I vow to make laughter, adventure, and joy a priority in our marriage, knowing that God has blessed us with one another. I promise to always keep your water bottle filled and to never, ever turn the big light on.
Thank you.
And lastly, I vow to give you my full commitment and enduring loyalty as the one and only woman whom my heart loves.
Well done.
Love you too.
Now, Kaitlynn. Kaitlynn now is going to share her vows.
Oh,
my. You guys are doing amazing. Here we are.
Okay. Can't see.
That's right.
I, Kaitlynn Marie Lohman, take thee, Austin Paul Campbell, to be my lawfully wedded husband. On our first date, I thought you could be the one because you loved dogs and had a dachshund. But by the end of our date, I knew you were the one because you told me how much you love God and led us in our first prayer together. I prayed for many years that God would lead me to his choice. And I praise him today that his will is being fulfilled. When I am with you, I am my best version of myself. Thank you for accepting me for all that I am. I vow to faithfully love you without reservation. I vow to do my best to give more than to take. I vow to raise our family together under the care and guidance of God. I promise to encourage you, you inspire you, and stand by you, and to stand up for you. I promise to laugh with you, cry with you, and grow with you. I will hold your hand with every one of our days together. I promise to be the best wife and best friend, to honor, love, and cherish you through all life's adventures. I say all these things knowing that God is in the midst of them all. I am thankful to be in love with my best friend. I love you.
I love you too.
Wow.
I love you.
Me too.
Well done.
Thank you.
You're well done. And you got through it.
Thank you.
You did good. You did amazing.
Thank you.
You ready? Mm-hmm. All right, now they would like to exchange rings. All right, Austin, put that on Kaitlynn's finger. Which finger do you want? Perfect. Okay. Mm-hmm. Perfect. Repeat after me, Austin. As a pledge.
As I pledge.
And in token.
And in token.
Of the vows.
Of the vows.
Between us made.
Between us made.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
The Son.
The Son.
And Holy Spirit.
And the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
Well done. Perfect. Perfect.
Perfect.
All right. Now, would you like to get your ring that Kaitlynn's going to give you? Repeat after me, Kaitlynn. As a pledge.
As a pledge.
And in token.
And in token.
Of the vows.
Of the vows.
Between us made.
Between us made.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
The Son.
The Son.
And the Holy Spirit.
And the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
Well done. Now, very often at this part of a ceremony, we usually have, or sometimes we have, a unity candle. Or possibly even, I've seen M&Ms mixed in a jar, and I've seen sand mixed in. They have something very unique that they want to do as their solemn vow here on behalf of the Unity Candle right after they've said the exchange of rings. And what is that that you want to do?
A pinky promise.
A pinky promise.
All right, go do it.
All right.
Amen.
I love you.
That is awesome. Pray with me, please. Father, what a joy it is to be here on this beautiful day, this day of celebration, the excitement of this young couple on these beautiful grounds. Thank you for these two families, for the Lohman and Campbell family, and ask your continued blessing upon their homes and all the relatives that are here and friends and those who are standing with them. What a beautiful group of people. And we just give you the glory for this day, Lord. This is a gift from you. And we thank you for it. You didn't have to do this, but we're very grateful, and we'll give you the honor for that. And we thank you for all this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
What God has joined together, let not man put asunder, for as much as Austin and Kaitlynn have consented together in holy wedlock and have witnessed the same before God and this company, I now pronounce them husband and wife in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. You may now kiss your bride.
Oh my goodness.
Okay, yep. May I introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. Austin Campbell. Now, you should have some petals there available. They want them thrown up high as they walk down, as they go by you each row, just your row, Dellet, and the next row, and right on out. All right, Mr. and Mrs. Austin Campbell.